age of that.
So, with all the challenges experienced by the students and parents over the past 2 years, we figured it might be helpful to share a few tips on making the homeschooling experience a much smoother one. Yeah, we were talking about it at the start of the show, Sim and I. So the first one says, create a designated learning space. So I guess them can learn in the bedroom and the kitchen and the living room. So you have to have a little spot. It says, living and learning under the same roof can quickly lead to disorganization and chaos. So to avoid confusion, try to keep your kids' study materials organized and designate a specific learning hub, a space where they keep supplies and books. That makes sense.
If you have the space.
If you have the space. But that makes sense, because you don't want, as I say, you don't want to be doing schoolwork in the
paint. If you don't have the space, then it's a problem. But if you have the space.
Yeah. What's the next one?
Follow a daily schedule. Children thrive when they have a basic structure and routine. So consider creating and following a daily schedule, which will give both parents and children focus and direction for each day.
So they have like a steady lunch time and they have play time, just like...
Like you at school.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Set learning goals together. What does that mean now?
As a parent or teacher, you can outline some key learning objectives for your child ahead of time. Once you have some broad objectives and benchmarks, sit down with your child and get their input. Working together to set learning goals is also a great opportunity to teach your child goal setting skills and best practices. So tell them what you want them to achieve. We're aiming for a 90 at the end of the term.
Okay.
We're going to, every weekend, we're going to read over the notes for the week.
And, okay.
Right?
You kind of do that right now, don't you?
I have to.
Yeah.
I have to. Yeah.
Number four says, take learning beyond the classroom. Mm. What is that about now?
You read, Nev. My teeth are clenching.
It says one of the best ways to reinforce learning at home is to take it beyond the traditional classroom setting and engage in activities that incorporate play and real-life scenarios. So look for learning opportunities beyond the textbooks. Play board games, practice baking and cooking, learn household management skills like laundry or simply budgeting, etc. And this makes for a more well-rounded curriculum. But don't you have to follow the school curriculum? Or you don't have to follow?
You should. If you want them in the traditional school system, then you should.
But all them things, they don't happen at a regular school. They don't play a board game and...
It don't matter. You can follow, you can teach things on the curriculum in non-conventional ways.
Yeah, you can use football and...
You can use Monopoly to teach them math, you know?
Which is true, yeah. Mm-hmm. Number five.
Make learning a family activity.
So they say share your excitement for learning with your kids. Is there a subject or activity that everyone in the family enjoys? Perhaps you can learn from each other. So some family learning activities include reading together, exploring a new hobby, or making crafts.
Yeah. You can also create learning aids as well.
So learning aids are an excellent way to supplement lessons, whether it is a series of flashcards or a few charts strategically placed around the house, they can go a long way in reinforcing key concepts.
Okay, this is good for adults too, but especially for kids. Breaks are necessary. Children...
Don't you follow the daily schedule?
What? Breaks?
Yeah, it says follow a daily schedule. So not the kind of same thing, type of thing.
I guess, but sometimes I sit for long, long periods, you know, because the classes are sometimes an hour long. They may have three classes back to back. It says children don't sit at their desks all day at school. They have snack time, breaks and lunch, and they change between classes or subjects. Allow for this time in your day. If you notice your child is losing focus, that's okay. Take a break, walk around, go outside, have a snack, or change to a different subject.
All right, so this one kind of helped me, because if you're trying to do it the way you do it at school, then you would schedule your regular break time, whether you want to call it, and you have recess, then you have lunch, whether you want, whatever you want to call it. But if you're at school, you can't just get up and say, well, may I lose the focus, so I'm going outside and walk up and down.
So the beauty of homeschooling is that you can say school is from 9 to 12.
And 12 o'clock,
of course. And you teach 9 to 12 and 12 o'clock, your child goes outside and play.
That is the name of...
You could say school is from 12 to 3.
That's the name of that too.
And that's it.
Yeah.
Right? Once you get the education in, it gives you the flexibility of the home.
Yeah, I am thinking that, if you are going to homeschool right through the child's school life, I guess you can do what you want. But at the same time, if the child will end up going back to school, you don't want them to be totally different from what happens at school, which mm-hmm. is what I was thinking here. Mm-hmm. It says compassion and patience are key. Each child is different, and we should understand this adjustment period is difficult on them too. They will miss their friends, their teachers, and the normalcy of school. If they exhibit behaviors of frustration, show them love and compassion and listen to them.
Yep. Next one says, parents need self-care too. Doubling as a parent and a teacher can prove challenging at times. It's important to make sure you create time for yourself. So exercise, phone a friend, take a bath, read a book. Whatever makes you happy, do your best to create the time and the space to get it done.
And the final one says, connect with other parents. Sharing is caring. And connecting with other parents can be beneficial in a number of ways. It allows for parents to share resources, learn from each other's experiences, and possibly provides opportunities for the development of a community based around the needs of your child. So hope that helped in case you are thinking of homeschooling. All right, we're going to take a break. The second edition of News in 5 comes up in 3 minutes. Stay with us, please. Soon come.